Let it go, baby. Where is it?
Yes.
Can you see it?
Wow. Who's this then? Tell me about who we're looking at here.
Rosie Boo.
She's called Rosie Boo.
Rosie Boo. Yeah. And Rosie Boo, I believe, is named after you. Is that right?
She is. Isn't she, Rosie? She named after you. She got your boots?
Yeah.
Yeah. And your hair that you used to have.
Dad, Jason, it's not every day a little girl gets a doll named after her, but just talk to me about how this all came about.
We have Lottie doll toys. So we have the treehouse and the dolls. For a number of years, we wanted to do a treehouse in the garden, basically, but we couldn't agree on a design. And then we suddenly realised, well, we've got perfect design with this thing. And so we had someone make that, which was the full-size version. And then after that, Lottie got hold of all this going on. And Ian, who is the CEO of Lottie, basically said, well, we want to make Rosie a doll for Christmas. And so this is the prototype that they made. So this is the first version. And that's the one in the box.
Wow.
And now it's gone into production. So now it's available. It's had some slight modifications to it, but it's got her boots. The final version's got odd socks, slight changes to the face and things, but we've got lots of information in the box about Down syndrome and what it means and what makes someone that has Down syndrome different. It's now for sale in 35 countries.
And, of course, this doll also, not only is it named after Rosie, it looks like her as well. I mean, how important do you think it is for her to have someone that looks like her?
This haircut actually came from her cutting her own hair, so she actually did a terrible haircut on herself. And so that's what they based the haircut on, because it looked exactly like her at the time. But I think it's really important to have, you know, kids play with dolls that are more realistic than the typical dolls that have got weird body shapes and things like that. Primarily, you know, this is not a doll. This is not promoted as a doll with Down syndrome. It's a doll called Rosie Boo, and it just happens to have information there about Down syndrome, and it's obviously based on her. So it has the attributes of a Down syndrome child. But it's done to get kids playing with dolls that are like, you know, like them, and normalise that for everyone.
We know bullying is a big problem, and I guess teaching kids about differences young as well is so important, isn't it? Because it can stop bullying further down the line.
Well, exactly, and that's what it's all about. I mean, Rosie doesn't know she's any different from anyone else, and she just gets on with life, and she has four siblings that treat her exactly the same as anyone else. And I think that's one of the biggest things that she's got out of this, is that her life is that she's not treated any differently by us. You know, she has learning difficulties and she has physical difficulties that are different from other people, but we're just trying to treat her the same as anyone else. And I think if more people do that with children that have differences, then it's going to be a better world.
Well, it's been really lovely to meet you, and albeit very briefly, Rosie, and of course her very special dolly. Is she still with us, the dolly at least?
The doll is, yep.
Rosie Boo. Well, we'll look out for her. Thank you so much, and
thank
take
you.
Care. All the best.
Thank
Bye-bye.
You. Bye.